today I'm reviewing the Peach & Lily Glass Skin Water Gel Moisturizer. And really quick, I just want to say I purchase all these products with my own money. I'll never waste your time with sponsored ads or videos, so if you want to help support the channel, check out NoBSBeauty.com, join my Patreon community, or click on the links below. Okay, so this is the latest addition to the Glass Skin Collection from Peach & Lily. I got an email from them recently. It sounds like they're coming out with a vitamin C serum. I'm very excited to try that one out, so we'll see when it comes out. But anyway, okay. So this joins the serum and the mist to the Glass Skin Collection. They call it the perfect end to your skincare routine. Our new Glass Skin Water Gel Moisturizer provides instant and long-lasting hydration for a glass skin glow. This breakthrough formula delivers a proprietary vegan prebiotic and probiotic complex that strengthens your skin's natural biome, the environment in which your skin functions, to strengthen skin and curb breakouts. So, very exciting. Love Peach & Lily for the most part. I'm a fangirl. Is that a thing, a fangirl? By the way, I was going for a really demure look today, and then I put my eyeshadow on and blew that one out of the water. But too glittery to even remove, so. Okay, my first criteria is packaging, and no issues with the packaging. It's a little heavy, so if you're going to travel a lot, glass bottle might not be easiest, but packaging is very nice. In terms of denatured or drying types of alcohol, this does not contain any of those, and it is also fragrance-free and has no real noticeable, tangible scent to it, so that's a good thing for a lot of people. In terms of the manufacturing location, this one is made in Korea, so no issues with that. Ease of use, so they recommend this to be used as the last step of your skincare routine. Use it morning and evening. Great for all skin types, especially oily and acne-prone skin. For dry, normal skin, personally, I recommend using this as a moisturizer and then using, if it's nighttime, a sleeping mask over it or an oil. They recommend using their Pure Beam Luxe Oil, which is pretty decent oil. It's no fragrance or anything. I don't think I've reviewed it yet. I should do that, though. But anyway, so smooths over skin easily, absorbs pretty quickly, sets to a natural finish. I had no issues with it pilling, except for under a couple different sunscreens that I was testing at the time. Usually sunscreens that contained a lot of sodium hyaluronic or hyaluronic acid, but this was, I don't attribute it to the moisturizer as much as the sunscreen itself. So very easy to use, no issues at all. It's, if you have very dry skin, I personally do think a thicker moisturizer is a key, especially in your evening routine. So very easy to use, no issues at all with that. In terms of antioxidants and beneficial ingredients, we've got a nice list here. We've got calendula extract, which is a marigold skin soothing antioxidant ingredient. Although I've read a few people, some people can be sensitive to this ingredient, so keep that one in mind. We've got sodium hyaluronic, which is a humectant. We've got hydrolyzed hyaluronic, which is a low molecular weight hyaluronic acid that is better absorbed, which is probably why I find two products, when you apply one after another, that contain hyaluronic acid or sodium hyaluronic, when you apply them right before or after each other, it just increases the chance of pilling. So that's probably why those sunscreens pilled. Personally, I guess if I'm going to see hyaluronic acid on a list, I'd rather see it in my moisturizer than in my sunscreen. That's just my personal preference. We've got kiwi extract, which is a good hydrating ingredient. We've got peach fruit extract, obviously a good moisturizing ingredient that contains small amounts of vitamin A as well as vitamin C. We've got chamomile water, which is a skin soothing ingredient. Bamboo extract, which is a good skin conditioning and hydrating ingredient. Burdock root, a good antioxidant skin soothing ingredient. We've got mulberry root and leaf extract, which are also antioxidants. Celery, which is a skin conditioning ingredient. We've got that lactobacillus extract, which is skin conditioning soothing prebiotic. Beta-glucan, soothing and moisturizing ingredient. Fructooligosaccharides, humectant. Licorice root, skin soothing and brightening. Camu Camu, soothing, hydrating, and brightening ingredient. Neem extract, good for skin conditioning. Neem extract is good. Neem oil, not so good. Then vitamin E, antioxidant and hydrating. So a nice list of beneficial ingredients in this one. So got some good antioxidants, skin soothing ingredients, and hydrating ingredients. So very good for moisturizer. In terms of animal testing, this is cruelty-free, vegan, and gluten-free. The trifecta. In terms of performance, nicely hydrating, and it doesn't feel greasy at all. It sets to kind of a natural finish. So for very dry skin, probably works best under an oil or a thicker moisturizer. For summer, I could probably use this on its own without any issues and need for another moisturizer. Probably mostly geared towards oily or acne-prone skin because of just how natural it sets to a finish. And then not many acneogenic ingredients. We've only got a few. We've got butylene glycol, carbamer, and then vitamin E. So none of those are hugely comedogenic. So price. So it's about $40. This is a full size 1.7 ounces or 50 milliliters. It's slightly above like the average price for Peach and Lily products, but not ridiculously expensive. I mean, a little bit of it goes a very long way, so that's nice. So I had a hard time deciding if this would be too expensive or affordable. So I decided it was affordable because a little bit goes a long way. So still might be too expensive for a lot of people, especially just for a moisturizer. Then in terms of the it factor, I really like it. It's a really nice moisturizer that most skin types can use. Lots of good ingredients, no fragrance, no alcohol, it's cruelty-free. It's a good product all the way around. It's not an earth-shattering, life-changing product. Their serum was a pretty amazing. This one's pretty good, but not life-altering like the serum was. Like, it just made my routine easier. This one's somewhere in the middle. So I still really like it. It's a good product. Although I'm very excited to see what their vitamin C is going to be. I'm assuming it's going to have some sort of peach or kiwi in there. So, I don't know. I guess we'll find out. But anyway, with a 10 being a perfect score, I gave this one a 10. A little touch and go there when it came to the price. But I decided it's good enough to have a 10. So, anyway, I'm interested in hearing from you guys if you've had a chance to try this yet or not. And if you have what your thoughts are. So, definitely leave a comment. Love hearing from you guys. And stay tuned for more tomorrow. Thank you so much.